Children, come forward. It's children's story time.
Just my mother that said it. Jesus said the same thing in Matthew and Luke. In fact, Luke 6:12 says, "And just as you want men to do to you, you do also to them." In fact, in Luke 6:27 through 28, Jesus said, "But I tell you who hear me, love your enemies, do good to those who hate you, bless those who curse you, and pray for those who mistreat you." Well, it's real easy to love somebody that loves you. But love your enemies? I mean, when I thought about enemies as a little girl, I would think of some guy with armor on that was coming with me with a sword. But in life, it's really not like that. It's usually somebody that we encounter in life, and they try to hurt us with words or actions. And maybe it's a bully or someone that's jealous of us. And as we get older, it could be a coworker on the job or a neighbor, a roommate, a careless driver that maybe cuts us off in traffic, or even a family member or a spouse. So usually when someone does something to hurt us, it seems in our nature to want to get even. But the Bible clearly says that this is not the right attitude. Leviticus 19:18 says, "You shall not take vengeance or bear a grudge against any of your people, but you shall love your neighbor as yourself. I am the Lord." So what are we supposed to do when somebody's mean to us? Well, the Bible tells us that we do good to those that hate us, we bless those who curse us, and we pray for those who mistreat us. So, it's not enough just to force a smile and mind your own business when we're hated or mistreated. We are to actively try to do good. You know, when Jesus came into the world, they had to come up with a new word in Greek for love. Agape love. That's the kind of love that doesn't serve itself, but extends itself for the sake of others. Agape love is the kind of love that we as Christians need and need to reflect. It is the love that we can possess only if Jesus is living in us. So how do we do it? We just don't wait for emotions of love. We start with actions of love, and the emotions will follow. We start doing what Jesus taught us to do. Do good. Try to find something that you can do good to that person. Not to shame him, but because you're trying to love him for Jesus' sake. Something that your own evil heart is hard to do. So I'm going to bless them. So when a person is slandering you or saying untrue things about you, find a way to have blessings in your thoughts. Don't go to your friends and complain about how you're being unjustly treated. Speak well of them. Why? To shame them? No. But King Solomon said in Proverbs 25 that it will be like heaping coals of fire on his head, and the Lord will reward you. We need to find it in our own heart to love that person. So pray and intercede. I know it's real easy to pray for your friends and your family, but you need to pray for your adversaries too. Pray that he'll help them, help them heal. heal the hurts that are probably is what motivating your feelings. Ask the Lord to bless them and show mercy on them. Why? To shame them? No. No, it's in order to find it in your heart to love them. Do this, and God will begin to put love in your heart towards your enemies. Actual love. John 13:34-35 says, "A new commandment I give you, that you love one another, just as I have loved you. You also are to love one another. And by this, all people will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another." Anybody want to pray? No volunteers? Okay, let's all pray. Our precious Heavenly Father, we ask that you help us love one another, Lord. We know that we're just like a kindergarten student when it comes to agape love. Lord, we ask that we will study your word and we'll pray and we'll try to have kind thoughts to those persons that are mean to us. And that we can reflect your character, Lord, so others may see it. And that we might be a light shining out to the world. And that we may glorify you.